Good morning, everyone. My name is Njoku Chiamaka. I'm here to make a presentation on a topic, multimedia teaching method and literacy. Multimedia teaching method. Multimedia teaching method and literacy. Multimedia entails two distinct words, multi and media. Multi means various, several. Media means a mix of transferring or conveying information. The multimedia is a means of using more than one medium to communicate to someone or to communicate something to somebody. It is an aspect of communication where various elements are used to convey information. For instance, multimedia have that element, and the element comprises of the content, the video, the animation, interaction with one another. For instance, as a teacher delivering a lesson on a topic, advertising media. If I'm to deliver a message on advertising media, as a business studies teacher, multimedia will play a very vital role, whereby we have signal, we have audio. Under audio, we can use the radio. Under signal, we can use this in an olden time, whether there is no television or radio to advertise your product to the public. Once you make a noise, this noise can, it will cause a lot of attention. People will come to know why you are making the sound. And when they come to you, begin to introduce your product. Buy pure water. With the noise, they will know that somebody is selling something. Also, when you see all these tailors, once they use their scissors to make noise, once you come out, it signifies that this noise is the person is sewing clothes. Even the shoemaker, all are all signal or sound. We have television, which is the vision. We call it audiovisual. Visual. Audiovisual advertising. You can use it, it's a multimedia. When you are televising your product to the public, now they can hear about the product. They can equally see how that product is being produced or how the product is being prepared. Also, we have the neon sign. It can serve as an animation where the product you're advertising will be going in a slow motion. Moving in a slow motion will make the public to know how this particular product can be prepared. Like during the Indomie advertisement or Bonvita advertisement, you see when they boil the hot water, pour it on the cup, mix everything before taking it. All these are the advertising media, and it's through medias that you can way different, you are using a different method to convey the information to the public or to the students. We have a teaching method as one of the keyword. teaching method. A teaching method is the approach used by the teacher to communicate to the student, and this method used by the teacher will determine the number of the students in a class. It's very important. The number of the students in a class. The number of the students in the class will tell you the approach you will use. Whether you will use the lecture method, or you will use the discussion method, or any method of teaching, or also maybe the number of the students is one, the sitting position is another one, the topic we are to deliver. Sometimes when we are delivering a topic on marketing, it will require a field trip where we can go outside there to see some business centers. But a topic like this advertising media or advertising, you can demonstrate it in the class using maybe a bell to be ringing, telling the student that you can ring the bell to call the attention of the people you want to advertise the product to. Another key word here is literacy. Literacy is the ability to read and write. Media literacy is the ability to access, analyze, evaluate, create, and act using all kinds of communication. You want to teach on a particular thing, like I said, this advertising media. Now we have told them you can use radio to advertise. You can use television to advertise. You can use bell to advertise. You can use sticker to advertise. You can use posters to advertise. You can use any kind of media to communicate what you intend to tell the public. Multimedia teaching method and literacy is an education that aims at increasing the student's understanding and enjoyment of how the media works and controls reality. When you are showing them the media, the student will begin to think. It makes them to think deep. It makes them to have a creative thinking. They'll be thinking, how can this thing work? How can it come to this? So it can be real. Like in that animation, where we can see that a table being a non-living object that don't supposed to move. With that animation, you will see table moving. The student will begin to imagine, how can a table move? And that's the importance of using this multimedia in teaching and learning. With the multimedia teaching and learning, you see so many students will be able to understand very well. If they cannot understand it verbally, they can understand it through visualizing it. The importance of multimedia in teaching method and literacy. One, it enhances deeper and better understanding of a topic using verbal and visual. That's the point I just mentioned. The second one, it encourages the students to express their knowledge in multiple ways. When you give them maybe a home task, you see the method one use might differ from the method the other one use, because we always ask them, the student, go home, research, go to cafe, make so many research, so that they can come out with multiple answers, and the answers are pointing at the same thing. It encourages the student on teamwork, in the sense that when you give them assignment also, this one will go to internet, this one will go, and when they come, they combine themselves and they will just do the discussion, and this one will say, this is what I find out, the other one will give his own point, the other person will give their own point, they discuss it within themselves, and give, when the teacher comes in, they'll be able to comprehend and follow up the teaching and learning. It helps the student at all age to research on the skill. Even our little children in primary school, with this multimedia, you see them carrying the handsets, pressing it all the time. There are some things that even the adults cannot be able to locate where it is in the handset. You find out that a little child will be able to do it because of the multimedia. The multimedia helped the children in a lot of ways. You see, one thing is that when the students have already known this, they go deeper. How this thing, I'm so surprised, how did this thing come to be? And before you know it, they'll say the reason for that. In conclusion, multimedia teaching method and literacy is very important. It is used to improve the learning process and increase the interaction between the student and the teacher. It makes both the student and teacher to be critically thinkers, effective communication, and active citizen, because they know they have gone wide. It's just like we know that today the world is really globally moving wide. It's really increasing. Both the children, the teachers, the adults, everyone wants to know why. When you open your handset, go to internet, you see a lot of things that can make you to research more. And that helps in teaching and learning. Thank you.